think about you every day. And I miss you. And I get scared. In case you're seeing someone else. Or texting other people. And I get scared you're stringing me along.
You do fucking annoy me. Sometimes.
And that's all I can think about, because I'm alone all the time.
You just go on and on and on and on and on.
And I know you're trying to help.
I just think about
you're getting in my fucking face all the time.
And it really winds me up.
Glad.
And it really, you know what, whenever any of you try to help,
I didn't really buy it for anything, any reason.
And it feels like I'm really sorry that you, I just want to disappear and get the fuck out.
I am.
I'm really sorry.
What happened to you?
To get away from
I am fucking,
I, you know, like,
I'm also pretty fucking,
what,
I'm
just really,
what is going on
to someone else?
What is going on?
Like,
I don't understand.
I think you're lazy. I think you're miserable.
I'm done.
Fucking scared.
What is going on? I don't understand why I fucking do this. I'm done. Is there something wrong? I think that might be. Maybe I should call a doctor.
What? That's what I should do, right? Or maybe just maybe I'm just tired. Maybe I'm sleepy. I'm run down. I've too much to drink. That's all.
Half of my time miserable.
Why the fuck would you say that?
You.
No wonder why she fucking left you.
Look at you.
No wonder why they won't text back. Pathetic. What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do about it? Do something.
What the fuck are you doing?
Probably because I could just have eaten.
Have you completely lost your mind?
Are you playing out? Where were you when I needed you?
Why are you so scared of?
Text her again.
Where were you when I needed you?
What are you so scared of? I never fucking liked you anyway.
What are you going to do about it?
Do something.
Have you completely lost your mind?
What are you so scared of? Text her again. What are you so scared of? I never fucking liked you anyway.
Probably because I was just a boy.
I'm not a boy no more.
So fuck you.
To be honest, Man, I've just been so fucking paranoid lately. And it had to come out some way.
Every day, it's a getting closer, going faster than a roller coaster. Love like yours will surely come my way. Hey, hey, hey. Every day, it's a getting faster. Everyone said, go ahead and and ask her. Love like yours will surely come my way. Hey, hey, hey. Every day seems a little longer. Every way love's a little stronger. Come what may, do you ever long for true love from me? Every day it's a getting closer, going faster than a roller coaster. Love like yours will surely come my way. Hey, hey, hey.
Someone's calling you. You got a phone call, baby. So you better pick it up. You've got a phone call, baby. Please speak up.
We are nothing without trees. They guide us like stars grown from the earth. Yeah, I wrote that one.
I mean, I've had a lot of sex. I just don't think I've ever made love.
So I just got this new lipstick in the shade of Coral Sex. And yeah, I don't know, I just really think it's one of those shades that makes you think, fuck you, Darren Bridesdale. I hope you're enjoying your milquetoast suburban life with your four kids and your skanky trophy wife. You know what I mean?
A lot of people say use a whole onion, but that's not true. You don't need to use a whole onion. The only people who want you to use a whole onion are the onion farmers. So they can get more money. I thought to myself, there's something about living that is simply gorgeous. It's just gorgeous. So I thought I could combine several of my passions, you know, like I love to cook. I love to bathe. I can have a glass of wine. I eat where I sleep. I sleep where I eat. I also shit where I eat.
See, I'm all about that natural connection with my writing at the moment. If you really think about it, it makes no sense, because we take trees and make them into paper and then write our words on it. But if you go up to a tree and listen and see what the tree has to say for itself, it's going to tell you a much more interesting story.
Oh, well, unfortunately, some of us just don't have the time.
I'd love to read one of your short stories if you get a chance. Send it over.
I don't just get likes by luck, I have my system. You've got to upload your photos between 5:30 and 6:30 p.m. Oh, and Sean, do you remember David from uni? Yeah, well, he's going out with Maria from Islington. And last night, he liked three of my holiday pics from 2017. At 11:15 p.m. That is wank time.
Oh, 11:15 is prime wank time. Oh, I wish there was some kind of just eats. But for sex. You know, not the sex work kind of way, but you know. You know, I agree with sex work. I'm a feminist.
I'm not gay.
Maybe something that's still pro women but screams that it gets to the job, like. Just eat her out. When it first started, when I saw an article online that said if you eat an orange in the shower, it releases its oils, which makes the shower a more sensual experience. And I thought, what the hell? But then I started going crazy. I went from an orange to an orange chicken to a bistro bath bomb. Oh.
See, actually, I've been spending my nights writing. I feel like the more I can deprive myself of sleep, the more higher my creative self comes. Like the other night, I was finishing a sonnet, and I don't know. It was amazing. I was reading this Emily Bronte poem to give me some inspiration. And it's like, as I was reading it, her spirit came into my soul. And, you know, the pen was flowing and she was flowing through me. And I was, it was like I was on the moors and I was dancing with Heathcliff. I'm not gay.
Oh, that really reminds me of the first time I had sex with the ghost of Barry-Ann. See, I was really struggling to get my daisy nail out just right. And I felt this gentle caress on my shoulder and this seductive northern voice saying, Amy, you're doing it fucking wrong. And he snatched the nail file out of my hand and... Well, that wasn't the only thing getting snatched that night. I have never since had a better lover. And you are talking to the girl who always pulls it Friday night bingo. 66, clittity clit.
Unfortunately, some of
69, dinner for two, you know what I mean?
It's so funny you should mention this because...
Speaking of paper mache, it really helped me get through a time when I accidentally...
Growing up in England at that time, it really affected me.
That Madonna was accidentally going to take 5 minutes and then left you...
Someone's calling you. You got a phone call, baby. So you better pick it up. You've got a phone call, baby. Please pick up.
Every day it's a getting closer, going faster than a roller coaster. Love like yours will surely come my way. It's a getting faster. Everyone said go ahead and ask her. Love like yours will surely come my way. Hey, hey, hey. Every day seems a little longer. Every way love's a little stronger. Come what may.
Take the shirt off.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, Kev, it's way too early for this. You still owe me 50 quid from poker last night.
I'm too hungover right now. I will pay pounds later. Only in the way you want it, only on the day you want it, only with the understanding, every single day you want it, only in the way you want it, only on the day you want it, only with the understanding, every single day you want it, you. What is it now?
Is that Joe?
Caleb?
Sorry, it's so early. But hello there.
Caleb Montgomery? It's been 6 years. You sound like a bear now.
Oh, well, you don't.
I can't. So,
what were you going to say?
No, nothing. You carry on.
I was just going to ask, how's home?
Same old dump, I guess. Still surviving. And Kev still, still Kev.
You and Kevin are still chatting?
Of course we are, mate.
Cool. So you sound like a bear as well.
More like a helium balloon. Listen, it's great to hear you, but why did you call?
He's thinking about you guys and fuck off. You know. I don't know, but I heard the song. Danny's favourite, Dog Days Are Over.
Nice.
Anyway, so I.
One hell of a gig, wasn't it?
Yeah. Do you remember when Florence was like, "Oh, everyone take their shirts off," and only Danny had the fucking balls to do it.
Couldn't wait to take it off. I bet.
Right, mate. Yeah. Well, I've got
sorry.
To...
My mate's just outside, so I'm just going to let him in.
Yeah. But it was lovely chatting to you as well, so I'm going to let you go. And give Kev a slap in the face of me.
Yeah.
See you later, cool. Mate. Ciao, ciao.
Ciao, ciao.
Yeah, bye.
Okay.
You're fucking gun. Come on.
Oh, this one, bottle left.
Hello?
Oh, hey, mate.
How you doing, mate?
Good. Thanks for the invite. How are you?
not too bad.
Hey, Cal. You ever played Doom?
No.
Oh, you're missing out, mate. This game is sick.
That shit bastard stuck up on me!
Oh no!
Oh, why I win! Woo! Last layer standing, bitches!
Oh, you cushy sod, Kev. Motherfucker.
Fucking mothers is more your remit though, Joe, isn't it?
It was only the one time.
Back to the game, Joe.
Yeah, right. Take my invite, we'll stay in the lobby for a while.
Oh, nice place you got there, eh, Cal?
Yes, yeah, it's not bad.
Yeah, potted plant and everything. Look at this one living like a king.
It's just a plant, Kev. Yeah, you've got your fucking paint photo, whatever they are, motherfucker. So what are you doing now then? Are you working?
No, following your uni, doing a speech therapy course.
Nice. Yeah. You enjoying?
Yeah, it's all right. What about you?
Yeah, uni too, final year. Degree in economics.
Oh, nice one, Cal. What uni?
Cambridge.
Fuck. Well, well done, mate.
Yeah, well done, mate. Mummy proud of a golden boy, is she?
I don't know. Probably. Does anyone remember the Florence concert?
What?
The Florence the Machine concert.
6 years ago.
Yeah.
Weird thing to be bringing up, Cal.
Sorry.
And you also hated it, Cal.
Well, I remember that Danny enjoyed it, so...
Why are we talking about
Danny? Actually.
Who cared what Danny thought?
Yeah, I did.
No, you
Why
didn't.
Why are we talking about Danny?
Yeah, actually, it was the opposite. Why are we here, Danny? Why the fuck are we here?
I get
you know,
that.
Me, Joe, and Kevin don't want to be here, Danny. Why are you dancing around like a prick, Danny? It's a pretty fucking weird thing to say to somebody if you thought you were
Well, happy. It was a mistake. Mistake. Yeah?
Yeah. Pretty big mistake, though, isn't it?
I'm going to change the settings so we can find a game faster.
My point is that I just...
Don't say you're sorry. You could have said that after it happened, or over the past 6 anniversaries, which you couldn't be bothered to come to, by the way. No offence, mate, but it's pretty fucking pointless saying it now.
I just need to...
Go on.
Actually, yeah. Fuck that. Never mind, fuck that.
If you think that the Danny thing is my fault, I don't know what to tell you. Because...
Can we just drop it? Please.
Yeah, I'd appreciate that too, actually.
Yeah. What was that?
Danny wasn't dead 6 months when he fucked off.
It wasn't his fault, Kev.
Wasn't it?
Washed it away down the kitchen sink. Well, there you are. Nice to finally meet you. Araminta, is it?
Minty.
That's quite exotic. Where are you from?
Kent.
So then obviously it's got the wooden flooring.
And... So basically, you've got OCD.
No, I'm just particular about things. It's completely normal.
So OCD then. Wait, look, there's someone. Hang on.
Ah, here he is, the mysterious Bobby. You got to turn your camera on, mate. Oh, I'm so sorry. I just called you he.
It's fine, mate. It happens all the time.
So there's the two bedrooms on the bottom floor. There's a bedroom on the top floor, which obviously will be mine because it's got the most privacy and the most space.
A main road feels a little too invasive for me. I like my privacy.
Yeah, I don't think it's the right house for like legendary parties.
Coco doesn't like parties.
Who's Coco?
My prize-winning thoroughbred cockapoo.
The pool, in the pool. And I had to go to A&E and get like 6 stitches. I don't know, like 6 or 7. And my mum was, you know.
So much space as well.
It makes me so happy.
Oh, I'm so relieved. I felt a panic attack coming on. I was about to give up.
Okay, great. I'll message the landlord and tell him that we can put a deposit down tomorrow. Great. Sweet. Okay.
Breaking news. This morning, as alien spacecraft land on British soil, the police and armed forces have been negotiating since dawn. But translators have informed us that the aliens have made clear they intend to destroy all university students enrolling for September 2020. Here's Michelle with some tips on how to keep safe.
Thank you, James. Yes, it is seeming to be a pretty dire situation. All university students are being told to stay inside, wear appropriate protective gear, and keep supplies of bleach topped up. Although it is unknown how dangerous these aliens might be, it is thought that they can be disarmed by stabbing them in one of their many hearts. Official government statements are urging the British public to stay inside, and if you do see an alien, do not attempt to make contact. This is Michelle for BBC News.
Coco, I told you, I'm trying to do my beauty regimen. Coco?
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thou shalt be done, as it is on earth. Amen.
You know, having purple skin really brings out the green in your eyes. Yeah, it's really weird.
Mom, I thought you were an alien.
Experienced an increasingly challenging time, a time of disruption in the life of our country, a disruption that has brought enormous changes to the daily lives of us all. the lives of our 2020 university students in particular. But we have succeeded. The aliens are no more. We have conquered this unknown species in the face of adversity. We might never know the motivation behind this cruel attack, but something we will forever remember as a nation is the importance of our university students. I would like to thank those of you who supported the nation in its victory, and those individuals who played a vital role in defeating the enemy.
Forget your troubles, come on, get happy. You better chase all your cares away. Shout hallelujah, come on, get happy. Get ready for the judgment day. The sun is shining, come on, get happy. The Lord is waiting to take your hand. Shout hallelujah, come on, get happy. We're going to the promised land. We're heading across the river, wash your sins away in the tide. It's all so peaceful on the other side. Forget your troubles, get happy, your cares fly away. Shout hallelujah, get happy, get ready for your judgment day. Shout hallelujah, come on, get happy. You better chase all your cares away. Shout hallelujah, come on, get happy. Get ready. Get ready. Get ready for the judgment day.
Alexa, play Mr. Mustafa.
Here's Mr. Mustafa by Alexandra Desplat on Amazon Music.
Where were the other runners? I thought I'd be able to get at least some motivation. Oh, there isn't even any dogs. That's actually really sad. Wait, this is weird. Why is no one around? Don't panic. Why are you panicking? This isn't 28 days later, Bella. For God's sake, stop shouting. Maybe it's too cold. Or maybe you missed a memo. Maybe it's National Stay Indoors Day. Or maybe... wait. No. Bella. Bella. Bella, calm. I can't be the only one left. What am I gonna do? Repopulate the fucking earth? Oh, I can barely make some toast, let alone fucking rebuild civilization. Oh, this can't be happening. This can't be happening. Oh, I need to find someone. There must be someone.
Tirei o pau ao gato, tu, mas o gato, tu, não morreu, eu. Dona Chica, que assustou-se, se, com o berro que o gato deu.
Miau!
Que caralho é este? Respira e conta. Um, dois, três, quatro, cinco, seis, sete, oito, nove.
To run today. You know, maybe if you were more disciplined, you could have better abs. Shut up. Love yourself. Fuck it, I'm going for the run. I've never walked on the road for this long before. Where are all the cars? Usually everyone's coming back from work about now. No one's here. Odd. No dog walkers. No fishermen. No old couples out for a wee stroll. Weird. I can't even hear the motorway. Bizarre. I could always hear the motorway. Why is no one answering? Fuck, 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 fuck. What's going on? Where is everyone? How did I not notice this sooner? This is what happens when you stay inside all day.
Thank you. 다들 요즘 많이 바쁘지? 그냥 안고 전화했다. 너희 엄마랑 아빠는 잘 지내고 있으니까 걱정하지 말고. 그리고 얼마 안 있으면 너희 엄마 생일인 거 알지? 그리고 그래, 그러면 일 봐라. 안 끊는다.
Over a period of 6 years, from 7th, one that would shock Benson's constituents, dishonor his office, and leave a catalogue of smuggling and deception in a quite breathtaking state. Lundy would play an important part in Benson's tale. Shortly after he became MP and Sheriff for Devon, Thomas Benson took the lease of the island, an island that was apparently uninhabited.
Hello? Yeah, I'm coming. What?
Next mission. But for now, the most important thing for everyone to do. Get us all through this is to maintain the spirit and the resolve that's had such an impact thus far. So please, stay at home, protect the NHS.
Going.
I'm good.
I just saw your wedding pictures. I'm sorry I couldn't
sorry,
make
I'm
it.
This is where we are.
Yeah.
Oh man, my wife seems upset again. I'll call you back. Just a sec. Hey.
Right.
Hey. Thank you.
엄마 그냥 그냥 전화했다고 어 So.